Jane, can you review the process guide as included in the Senior Living Sustainability Guide?
Yeah, so for this resource, what we've tried to do is utilize the social cultural context, because that's one of the problems that we're seeing with developing information. So we didn't have anything for sustainability, so we brought a group of volunteers together and put together this process guide. So it's not just sustainability of the building, like 189.3 just focuses on the built environment. This was an opportunity to look at resident desired outcomes, the organization, and what the management philosophy was, so it ties very nice to the environment of care. We look at the operations and the operation flows, and as much as it can make people a little crazy going through every single operational flow that happens in a building, that's what's suggested. And then it ties that up with a bow, so to speak, within the social cultural context. So that goes back to talking about the cultural relevance. So the woman, the Jewish woman living in Miami with a caregiver that comes from Jamaica is a good example of that, understanding what you're working with. And then the whole support mechanism is that the physical setting supports the other three dimensions. And that's always been where we've kind of fallen short within design. So this supports basically what's in the guidelines as a process guide. It gives people a little bit more information. And then we try to also look at the outcomes. Because one thing I think sustainability has a misnomer is it's not about a plaque on the wall. It's really about the outcomes and then remeasuring the outcomes. So we want continual improvement because people change. Processes change, technology change, organizations change, resident desired needs change. So when we look at that, always looking at that and refiltering it through. So that's how the process guide was set up to work.